Hello, it's EJ again, and this is the WCAG Documents project focused on web accessibility. In this video, I will talk about the WCAG criterion 144, resize text. You can also read it online at accessibility.actumdigital.com, where you will find more information. Let's get into it. The intent of this success criterion is that text can be enlarged up to 200% without loss of content or functionality. Who benefits from it? People with low vision can increase the text size and are able to read it. People with tired eyes can increase the text size, so reading is more comfortable. People with devices with a small screen or a distant screen, such as TV, can increase the text size to be able to read it. This criterion covers not only standard text like paragraphs, headings, and lists, but also text-based controls such as buttons or input fields. Users must be able to resize text up to 200% without assistive technologies using the following: operating system settings, adjusting text size settings in the device's operating system, browser zoom, using the browser zoom feature to enlarge web page content, browser font size settings, changing the default font size in browser settings, web page settings, adjusting the text size by controls on a web page. Although not required by WCAG, testing even further, for example with a 400% increase, can help ensure even better accessibility. Remember, tools like screen magnifiers or third-party browser extensions are considered assistive technologies, and achieving text resize using them does not count towards meeting this criterion. When text is scaled up to 200%, every web page element, including navigational links, interactive forms, and informational content, should remain fully functional and accessible. This means that the page layout should adapt to the increased text size without causing any loss of information or functionality. The text should not be clipped or obscured, and all interactive elements should remain operable. Captions and images of text are not included in the requirements of the success criterion. Let's take a look at some examples. The following examples show the correct usage or implementation of accessibility. Example 1. Relative font units. A website uses relative REM units for defining font sizes. When users change their font size in the browser settings, the browser respects this setting and renders the font in the size the user sets. For instance, a user with low vision may adjust their browser settings to make the text larger. Example 2. Meta viewport. A website is designed to be fully responsive. In its HTML, it has the following meta viewport tag: meta name equals viewport with content of width equals device width and initial scale equals 1. This settings allows users to freely zoom in and out on the content, accommodating their needs for larger text. The following examples show the incorrect usage or implementation of accessibility. Example 1. Fixed height. A news portal has its article sections styled with CSS, where the text containers have fixed heights. When a user with impaired vision increases the browser's default text size, the text within these containers overflows, becoming invisible or getting cut off. The fixed height of the containers doesn't allow the text to reflow, resulting in inaccessible content for users who need larger text. Example 2. Meta viewport. A website uses a restrictive meta viewport tag in its HTML. Meta name equals viewport, with content of user scalable equals no, and maximum scale equals 1. This prevents users from zooming into web pages. A user trying to enlarge the text for better readability finds that they are unable to zoom in at all. This limitation makes using the website difficult for users with visual impairments. And that was all for this video. Thank you for watching and see you at the next one. Have a nice day.